utterly appalled and disturbed that you would run a skit about taking callers out Lacey Peterson style. In my opinion, Tom, you're a satanic monster. And
I'm a satanic monster?
You know, every time I hear that thing you guys do, the skit about her death and her son's and her tummy death, I think of her in that
what?
Photo. I think of her in the red paternity outfit and Christmas necklace. And person on the wicker chair, Lacey Peterson.
Well, you know an awful lot about this case. Are you a stalker?
There's pictures of that picture. It's an infamous picture. I live in the Bay Area. And who do you think you are doing something like that? You probably have a kitchen table made out of plywood you sacrifice small animals on.
Really? Well, we give the people what they want. If they ask for that, we give it to them.
Well, you made it up. And you're the... You
That's
get it.
Because the listeners called and said this is what we want.
Well, don't you feel bad?
Oh, I'm as offended by it as you are.
Everybody at the dental office I work at, I'm a receptionist. We were really upset when we heard it.
So you were all listening?
You used to be on in the Bay Area, and that's probably why you got taken off. Because you
got taken off?
You're a mean...
Is that why you got taken out of high school? Because you get taken out of your English class?
I'm so upset right now. I can't even think straight.
You're going to break your radio?
No, I'm not. I'm... You know what? If I was in Hollywood and I seen you and you made a comment like that, I would put my frozen yogurt down and slap you.
Is that so? Who is this, Perez Hilton?
Look.
Listen, Perez, where Fidel Castro says hi.
Who do you think you are putting that on the radio?
I give the people what they want.
Yeah, well, I want you to fall on top of a rattlesnake in the desert.
Is that so? How old are you, son?
Don't call me son. You're not my dad.
How old are you, you dork?
I'm 23.
23? And you were in the slow lane in school? Is that the deal?
No, I'm sticking up for Lacey. And
you know what I mean?
You used to be ashamed of yourself, Tom. Who do you think you are playing that?
Well, you've said it. Do you have any other material? Is that all you're going to say?
Oh, no, I do got other.
Well, I'm listening. You're going to have to stop repeating the same line over and over.
Well, I just don't understand why you would make fun of people's death.
You've already said, like again, you're pretty much repeating the same sentiment.
But you didn't give me an answer. You
I said I give the people what they want.
You exemplified garbage. That doesn't make any sense. What do you mean? People don't want to hear that. Who wants that? I don't know anybody that wants that.
Well, again, you probably know people who are like you. There's plenty. There's people right now waiting for me to do it to you.
Do what?
To take you out Lacey Peterson stuff.
See, don't you just picture her in a wicker chair pregnant with a paternity outfit on and a Christmas necklace and... Emmer! Hey! Emmer! Emmer, miss you a few times. I live near the Red Lion Hotel and, you know, near the developments and kind of stuff your face with cold pizza all the time.
What?
You're probably one of those guys that has a border.
Is this Scott calling. Peterson?
You have probably...
This is Martha Scott Peterson calling from prison, isn't it?
You probably have Martha Stewart cheap sheets and you always brag about what you have. But you probably have
you know an awful lot about interior decorating stuff.
You probably have the thrift store goods, like... You wear the same thing a minute. I mean, you wear the same.
And you're a receptionist in a dental office.
You wear the same thing a mannequin does.
I mean, what university did you attend in order to be a receptionist in a dental office?
Actually, I'm going to school right now at Sonoma State.
To study to be what?
I'm going to be a graphic designer.
Right. You're 23. You're still in college.
So what? I was gonna do something else, but I changed careers. It's not about me. It's about you.
It's all about me.
You got bad woman syndrome because you can't get none. And you're probably like one of those guys.
You're actually attending a university.
Your underarms probably look like avocados. You probably don't wear deodorant. You smell like a decomposing possum. You probably, I don't know, you probably a yellow t-shirt that was the color white because you turned it inside out. You don't have a washing machine. Well, nobody likes you.
You sure have me pegged.
Yeah, but you can really even afford gas to go to La Jolla. Michael Savage.
Why would I want to go to La Jolla?
You and Michael Savage are the same kind of people. You guys come from the same drain pipe.
Is that so?
Yeah, you guys are two big cockroaches on the radio. That's why you guys are on radio. This is stupid, playing Lacey Peterson. You know, if you came to San Francisco and said that at a live show on Market Street, you'd probably get, I don't know, you'd probably get put in jail.
I heard something about you and Bernie Ward's drain pipe.
Oh, yeah.
That's
really
true?
Good. That's real good, Tom. You and Bernie Ward are the same shape. Same shape and size.
Well, I'm not in prison.
Yeah, well, I don't have clothes that go on a mannequin in the Goodwill store. Just because I'm ripping you apart.
Oh, boy, tearing me limb from limb.
I'm ripping you apart like a poster board inside of a pit bull's mouth. A pit bull's dental records. See,
are you that autistic kid who used to call it? I think you are.
Yeah, I think you're a rattlesnake in a petting zoo. Yeah, real funny. That's what you should do.
Your mama wears army boots.
Yeah, well, your mama didn't take vitamins.
Sticks and stones may break my bones.
Yeah, your mom did so much. Her tongue looked like bacon.
From a place we're not allowed to reveal, it's the Tom Likas Show.
Who the f*** is with this guy? Who is he?
And now, here he is, Tom Likas.
Thank you for tuning in to the Tom Likas Show. This is where America gets together to talk about the issues you really care about. It's a different kind of a radio talk program. We're the radio talk show that is not hosted by a right-wing wacko or a convicted felon. No. I am your host. Write down our telephone number. You're going to need it. It's 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866. Thank you for tuning in. Thanks for being part of our program. Here we are together again on the radio. May I just say, that it's been a fantastic Labor Day weekend. My plan was today to take today off. My plan was to stay in the pool and relax and enjoy myself. But in just a moment, I'll tell you why I came to work today. It's unbelievable. Put this in my lap, baby. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Before we get to anything, we are closing in on a location for the Tom Likas Taco Truck event, showing our support for the little guy. The guy who drives the taco truck is getting kicked around by the L.A. County supervisors. We are showing our support for the taco truck drivers, and we are going to get them all gathered in one place to sell their taco. And to show our support. And I think we're just about set. But if you've got a location better than what we've got, drop us a line here at tom@blowmeuptom.com. tom@blowmeuptom.com. Or call us here at 1-800-5800-TOM right now. 1-800-5800-866. If you have a big flat space where I can put about 50, 75, 100 taco trucks. Because I'm doing it. And I won't be satisfied until my mouth is full of carne asada. I mean, I want to have breath you don't want to get near for the next 2 weeks. Not that I don't already, but this is going to make it way worse than anything you can imagine. But that's my game plan. And I am hoping that we will get this together and we're going to get all the taco trucks together. This is going to be wild when we get it done. Now there's going to be tequila, and there's going to be partying, and it's going to be nuts. Nuts. Oh, we got plans. You have no idea. We got plans. If you got some big, flat, open space, private property. By the way, very nice of you guys to write in and suggest, why don't you try the Rose Bowl? Why don't you try Dodger Stadium? You think we didn't think of that? We thought about that. A lot of bureaucracy at those places. And we don't have, you know, 3 months to run it up the flagpole. This is topical now. So we need that space now. So if you've got a big open space for us, by the way, don't call us, tell us about your brother-in-law. Let me tell you about the emails we get. I don't want to know about your brother-in-law might have a space, your son might have a space, your grandfather might have a space. I'm talking about you. You have access and you can pull the trigger. If that's you, call us here at 1-800-5800-TOM. It's 1-800-5800-866. And if the lines are all full, just send it to tom@blowmeuptom.com. I'm sitting here online. And we are going through all these emails. And by the way, we do have a candidate for this in a great location. And if we close that deal, we'll let you know. But in the meantime, we're open to all comers, and I'm hoping to have something to announce soon. So if you've been thinking about doing this, get off your ass. Now's the time. Right now. So I decided to spend a lengthy period of time at my new home in Santa Barbara County. Weather, perfect. Pool, perfect temperature. Wine cellar, perfect temperature. And the idea was to spend this lengthy period of time just boozing, screwing around in the pool, going to the movies. That was my plan. And I planned to do it not only Labor Day and the days preceding Labor Day, I also planned on doing it today. Okay? But even though I'm vacationing and even though I've been enjoying myself, how do I resist this? How do I do it? In between watching the Jerry Lewis telethon, which I never miss because it's a train wreck in the making, in addition to watching the Jerry Lewis telethon with our friend Shotgun Tom Kelly doing the local inserts here in Los Angeles. By the way, anybody see Shotgun Tom reading the list of people who contributed? I don't know if the guys at the studio saw this, but he was reading this laundry list of names and cities where people were making pledges, and he had a pledge for a woman named Betty Wood. Did you hear about this? Yeah, he's reading Betty Wood's pledge, and he says, Betty Wood, and Betty did. She said $25. We love Shotgun Tom Kelly around here. We do. And I never missed the Jerry Lewis telethon. What was it? The news chick with the cans, was that Vera Jimenez? Oh, was there another news chick? I don't know. I think you're thinking of Vera Jimenez, who does the traffic in the morning on Channel 2. The chick with the cans. Thank you, Gary. Didn't notice anything else about her. The chick with the cans. Yeah, she's on at 5. She's on at 5 a.m. That's why you don't know. You're never up then? You'd be up if you were watching Vera Jimenez. I'll tell you what. You'd be bolt upright. But nonetheless, okay, so here I am, I'm on vacation, and I'm, you know, clicking around between watching the Dodgers win their first game in a week and a half and watching the muscular dystrophy telethon. It's a great Labor Day weekend. And what do I see? Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day. John McCain finally named a running mate. Now, this happened during Friday's show. And we mentioned it, Sarah Palin, governor of Alaska, no experience, 44 years old. How did we know what kind of tart her daughter would turn out to be? How did we know? How did we know? We didn't. We had no idea. Are you kidding me? Here's the statement from Sarah Palin and her husband, Todd. We have been blessed with five wonderful children who we all love with all our heart. Is it hearts? And mean everything to us. Grammatically incorrect. Our beautiful daughter, Bristol, came to us with news that, as parents, we knew would make her grow up faster than we had ever planned. Looks like she already had. We're proud of Bristol's decision to have her baby. And even prouder to become grandparents. She's almost 44 years old. What have I told you about white trash or trailer trash? Didn't we do a show about the youngest grandmothers? 44, she'll be like 40. She'll be 44, 45 and a grandmother. Are you kidding me? Says here, as Bristol faces the responsibilities of adulthood, she knows she has our unconditional love and support. Bristol and the young man she will marry. Have you seen this piece of work? He's a hockey player. Oh, yeah. Are going to realize very quickly the difficulties of raising a child. Especially because they're 17 years old! Which is why they will have the love and support of our entire family. Now, I love this. This Republican, the Republican Party, of course, was talking about whether Bill Clinton got oral sex in the Oval Office and whether Bill Clinton and his wife this, that, and the other thing. For years and years and years, the Republicans, you know, every little bit about Bill Clinton that ever came out, Jennifer Flowers, anything that ever happened in their family, blah-bitty-blah-bitty-blue. Well, guess what? Now they say, now that the shoe is on the other foot, now that we have the daughter of a vice presidential Republican running mate who's knocked up, they say, we ask the media to respect our daughter and Levy's privacy. Levy is the knocker-upper. As has always been the tradition of children of candidates. Yeah, but you see, darling, let me just say this, okay? The fact is that your lovely, wonderful daughter, Bristol, she's just so beautiful. Your lovely, wonderful, beautiful daughter, she is a product of you. You created this. You are the one out there telling people, oh, yes, about why they can't have abortions and your anti-sex education. You're in favor of doing nothing but teaching abstinence. How about you start teaching abstinence at home with that little slut, darling? How about you teach abstinence with that little tart you're raising? Going around out there getting five-holed by that hockey player. Were you teaching abstinence at home? You see how well that worked, sweetheart? You see how well teaching abstinence works with teenagers? Do you see how well that works? As soon as her hockey player boyfriend wanted to do a little high-sticking, she's in. And she was like a sieve, I might say, as they say in college hockey. Sieve, sieve, sieve. This is what they say about the goalie who can't stop the puck from going in the net. Let's just call her a sieve. You know what? I don't care what anybody says. This is open season. This is open season. And I heard on the news that despite what they say about supporting Sarah Palin, that the McCain people have gone to Alaska to do a little more vetting on their candidate. And I don't know what's happened lately, but the last I heard, they still had not announced the time that Sarah Palin would speak to the convention. Which leads me to believe it's still possible they will dump her ass from the ticket. But even if they don't, tell me this is not fair to talk about, that this is not fair game. After the years of going after people like John Kerry and his wife, years of going after people like Al Gore, years of going after Bill Clinton. Are you kidding me? Please respect our privacy at this very private time. F you. Your little slut is right here in my domain. I don't care what Barack Obama says. I don't work for Barack Obama. I'm not a registered Democrat. I'm not a registered Republican. I don't work for anybody's campaign. If Barack Obama thinks it's wrong for people to talk about this, I really don't care. That's what he has to say. That's what Barack Obama has to say. This stuff is off limits. Well, let me do some of the heavy lifting for Barack Obama and his campaign, okay? This is delicious. This is absolutely delicious that McCain picks this woman who, come on, gives every evidence of being trailer trash, in my opinion, okay, as his vice presidential running mate. By the way, take a look at some of the alleged photos of lovely Bristol and her her hockey boyfriend, Levy. Take a look on our MySpace. It's www.myspace.com/TOMLEYKIS. Take a look at the photos. These alleged photos with them, you gotta see, carrying guns. By the way, you see Levy's MySpace, which has been taken down? He said he doesn't want to have kids. You're having one now, pal! This is definitely within our bailiwick. It's definitely in our wheelhouse. It's definitely grist for our mill. And we really don't care if people think we should respect their privacy. What privacy? You're the vice presidential running mate of the Republican nominee for president. There is no goddamn privacy. There wasn't any privacy for Bill Clinton and Hillary Clinton and Chelsea Clinton. There was no privacy for Al and Tipper Gore. There was no privacy for John Kerry. F you. If the vice presidential running mate of the Republican nominee has a little slut as a daughter who gets knocked up because she's probably taught abstinence, and you see how well that worked, right, folks? Yeah. We're going to talk about it, and there's not a goddamn thing anybody can do about it. Here is your opportunity, because believe me, on those AM conservative talk shows, where these guys are running around defending this. Oh, it's so wonderful. It proves that her pro-life stance is consistent because, you know, they're keeping the baby. And so, therefore, we should respect their privacy at this very delicate time. Screw all of you. We're talking about it. And there's nothing you can do. If you have something to say about Bristol Palin and her coming crumb cruncher, this is the place to do it right now. Now,
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. Likas. 1-800-5800-866.
My husband listens to your radio station. Every time he comes home after listening to your radio station, he's like in a bad mood.
Really?
All the time.
He must enjoy it. He listens all the time.
Oh, no. I don't know what it is. You're just brainwashing him somehow, and I don't like that.
It's the Tom Likas Show.
The Tom Likas Show. Is there any doubt that we're here with a brand spanking new show? 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. Let's say hi to Lauren on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello.
Yes?
I just was calling in because I just don't really think the girl's a slut because she's pregnant. I mean, she's 70 years old. She has sex with her boyfriend. Fortunately, she got pregnant. She's
going to
keep the baby. That doesn't
technically
make her a slut.
Well, put it this way. Maybe it doesn't make her a slut. Hey, zero tolerance policy. You're out! You bitch. 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. Jim is listening to the online stream in Pittsburgh on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, Tom. I love you, man.
Thank you, Jim.
I think you're dead on with everything. Can you imagine if this was Chelsea Clinton, what they would be saying?
Of course, you know exactly what they'd be saying. Do you think if Chelsea Clinton got knocked up when Bill Clinton was president, they would have respected her privacy? Are you kidding?
That's all I wanted to say, Tom. You're dead on, man. It makes me sick to my stomach. I love you. I wish you were on here. It makes me sick you're not on here.
Call your local station, Jim.
I do, brother.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate the call. Here's Al on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello?
Is that a question or a statement?
No. I my ears are messy. Anyway, listen, I agree. I think that you're right up there. It all makes sense. And, you know, I wasn't sure. I'm still not sure about the Obama guy. You know, I was hoping John McCain, you know, could pull this thing out. But you know what? With this decision and the
running hoping Bristol. You know what? I was hoping Bristol Palin's boyfriend could pull this thing out, but he couldn't apparently.
You know, the thing is that I had a little hope for John McCain, but you know, pulling this thing and then getting this lady with the pregnant teenager, it just shows. You know, the lady can't even take care of her own house. So how is she going to take care of this country? You know,
by the way, I might add, this woman who's going to leave Alaska for Washington.
Listen.
She has a
You're going to clean the White House.
It's worse. No, you're not hearing me.
Okay.
It's worse.
Yeah.
She has a 4-month-old child herself with Down syndrome.
What's going on?
And she is going to leave a 4-month-old child with Down syndrome? Where? Yeah. Who's going to take care of that kid?
Start being busy being a mommy and a grandmommy. And, you know, and leave the country to somebody else. My God.
Oh, my God. Can you imagine if McCain is 72 years old. Can you imagine if Kane bit the big one?
God forbid he has a heart attack, and then she's left in charge.
Oh, my God.
Not a good thing, John McCain. Not a good thing.
Al, thank you for that.
Thanks, sir.
Appreciate the call. Here's Levi on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
How are you doing today?
Do you care?
Do I care? Yes, I care. I just wanted to make sure that you're comfortable because you're not in your beautiful little house there in Santa Barbara, that this great nation that keeps doing the exact same thing over and over and gives you a job and something to talk about has
As they will until I'm 185 years old. It'll never stop.
Yeah, so what's the big deal then? Well, this is our nation, right? This is what you live off of.
I do.
This is what your whole job there and
That's
everybody
right.
who's employed by you depends on.
That's right. We depend
so
on
we,
stupid
so
stuff like
this.
Should
we go away? Should we cry like little babies?
I'm not saying we should. I'm just saying no one's going to stop me from doing it. No one's going to stop me from talking. We should respect their privacy at this delicate time. F you.
Yeah, it's really cool that she's 17, a little kid, right?
That's what she is, a little kid who got knocked up.
So I really hope that she hears your wonderful show so that maybe she can make it through the pregnancy before she decides to split her wrist because she feels so bad, right?
I couldn't care less what she does. It's not my problem. It's her mommy who decided to leave the 4-month-old with Down syndrome at home so mommy could go be a gun nut in Washington. But on top of that, your mommy is so busy being the governor, she has no time to watch out to see if her daughter's legs stay closed.
So let's get this right then, Tom. So right now you're not excited that you have something to have a job about. You think that
Oh, I completely love it. No. Don't misunderstand. I came in from vacation for this. And the reason I did is because it's delicious.
Well, that's the first thing I said. I wanted to make sure that your feelings are not hurt by any of this.
My feelings aren't hurt. I just want to remind everybody who has gone through the garbage cans of Bill and Hillary Clinton and Chelsea Clinton and Al and Tipper Gore and John Kerry with the Swift voters and all that. I just want to remind everybody that nobody's privacy was respected at their delicate times, and I'm not respecting anybody's privacy now.
Well, it's great that you're here to provide a customer service for us, and I appreciate that. I'm sure everyone across America really appreciates this little conversation.
Good.
You know, the good thing about your show is that, yeah, I'm listening. Hypocritical, maybe. Do I like you? Not at all. But I'm sure a million people love you right now and are up in arms just cheering for you because you're such a great guy bashing this poor little 17-year-old girl. Who cares
Slut.
If she's a person? Because she's
tart. Part
of a party.
A little tart. A little pregnant tart is what she's
hey,
a pop tart.
Did you choose your in-laws? Did you marry your in-laws or did you marry your wife?
What does that have to do with anything?
It has everything to do with exactly what you're arguing, man.
Did Pop-Tart choose to become knocked up here?
Does your show reach listeners that are under 17 and talk about jugs and how wonderful the news lady looked on Jerry Lewis?
We also talk about using condoms on this show, which obviously the daughter of the vice presidential running mate of the Republican nominee doesn't talk about.
Well, let's go back to abstinence, because I believe that's what you were arguing she should.
Yeah. How'd that abstinence policy work in the home of Sarah Palin?
I assume Juggs was referring to cartons.
I'm asking you a question. How did the abstinence only policy work in the home of the woman who advocates it?
I'm sure it's working well right now.
Really?
Well,
her daughter got knocked up. How well is it working?
Well, I'm sure they're talking a whole bunch about pregnancy and sex right now while they're trying to convince their daughter.
It's a little late, for Christ's sake.
Tom Likas, 1-800-5800-TOM, 1-800-5800-866.
I want to thank you for telling all these guys out here what's really going on and how to save them time, money, and trouble. You're absolutely right, and I need to thank you for saving all the souls that I don't even know. Just thank you.
It's the Tom Likas Show.
The Tom Likas Show. Congratulate me. Come on. Say congratulations. This marks our 11th anniversary on 97.1 KLSX in Los Angeles. 11th anniversary. By the way, married and divorced four times. How many 11th anniversaries have I had? That's right. None. 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. Thank you so much for tuning in. I came in for vacation. Vacation. Because of the story of little slut Bristol Palin and her mom who wants to be the vice president. With her Down syndrome child of 4 months who's going to be left behind while mommy goes to Washington. I came in. I was on vacation. I was in the pool. Literally in the pool. I got out of the pool for this. Are you kidding? 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. Let's say hello here to Brad on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
How are you doing, Tom?
Doing great, Brad.
Yeah, I gotta tell you something. This is some crazy stuff with this guy. I quote, "We're proud of Bristol's decision to have her baby." That's what she says, right? She wouldn't even have a decision if it were up to her policies to have the baby or not. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
That's just crazy, Tom. That's all I wanted to say. But that's just nuts, man.
Good point, Brad. Thank you for that. Let's say hi to Kevin on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Father.
Son, how are you?
I'm excellent. I just wanted to say I support you with harassing Bristol. I mean, that caller that you just had that said, you know, oh, poor her. I don't believe that for a second. I mean, who does he think he is? Just because she's old? I mean, if she's old enough to have kids, why isn't she old enough to get hounded like the rest of us, you know?
Exactly.
Serious. I mean, that guy seriously needs to check on how the media runs in this country. And I mean, I support your decision 110%, sir.
Well, thank you for that, Kevin. There was no way I was not coming to work. There was a microphone nearby, and I grabbed it.
I love it. I love it. I've heard the coverage all day. I've heard all these excuses for it. But you know what? I mean, if she's old enough to make that decision for her body, she's old enough to be on the news for it. You know?
That's right.
All right, thank you, Father. I just wanted to say that, and I'll talk to you later.
Kevin, thank you. Scott on the Tom Likas Show, hello.
Congratulations on number 11, first of all, Tom. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Also, thanks for getting out of the pool for this. I think this is a great issue, And my question is, the Republican Party has got to have known that this was going to surface. So it almost leads you to believe that, you know, they want to go out on a self-destructive note other than their political platform since
you know what?
Apart.
I'm not sure how much they knew. I'm just not sure how much they knew. Maybe they knew the daughter was pregnant. But did they know all the details? Did they know about the MySpaces, the MySpace pages? Did they know about the fact that the knocker-upper said he doesn't want to have kids? Did they know about the fact that there's all kinds of photos on the Internet? Fascinating stuff. If you go to our MySpace, you'll see it all there.
Yeah, you got to know that they're going to attribute this to their demise rather than their political platform, though, which is pretty hilarious if you think about it.
Well, of course they are. But let's face it. What is McCain's platform? Yeah. I'm George Bush, and I'm going to continue the policies of the last 8 years. That's his platform.
There you go, Tom. There you go. All right. Thank you. That's all I wanted to say.
Thank you. Appreciate the call. It's 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. Rob on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, Tom. You know, you're very entertaining. However, on this one, I just think you're a huge hypocrite. You're calling that daughter a 17-year-old slut, but you're probably the biggest man whore out there. So unless you can confess.
Oh, I'm a big man whore, but you know what? Guess what? I'm a man. Guess what? I am a man whore who uses condoms.
Yeah.
So I am a man whore. I am a man whore. I am a man whore who has never had to make excuses for somebody being pregnant. Ever. Ever. Ever.
Why? So what's your excuse then that's so horrible? Since you don't have to make excuses, and excuses are so bad, what's your excuse that's so bad?
What?
You're saying you never had to make excuses because you used a condom, and
that's
yet
right.
You know you treat her like she's such an evil person. You yourself, you probably banged and slanged, hit it and quit it.
But guess what? This is somebody whose mother is running for vice president and telling everybody about abstinence only. All you can't teach about. You can't have sex education in school. You can't have abortions. You can't. It's all about. It's all about abstinence.
Yeah, but
how is the abstinence program working in the home of the woman who advocates it? I'm asking you.
I know. It doesn't work, but people don't criticize Al Gore's son when he's caught smoking pot. Even though
actually, they did.
Did they?
Yeah,
yes. You did too.
I have smoked pot, so why would I be critical of that?
Because that's against the law. Having a kid isn't.
And by
the
way, you probably haven't. Having a kid is not against the law. In Alaska, the age of consent is 16, so it's not against the law.
Yeah, exactly. And so you're more critical to someone who had a kid on her own choice than someone who's
I'm not talking about people breaking the law. I'm talking about people who advocate one thing while something else is going in their home altogether.
Uh-huh. And what, so people can't, be redeemed from their mistakes? For crying out loud, Clinton...
Redeemed from their mistakes! This woman is trying to prevent sex education in schools. She's trying to ban abortion. And meantime, her daughter is a little tart.
So what's so wrong about banning an abortion? I think she has more nuts than
what do you mean what's wrong with banning abortion? If they don't want to have abortion in their home, they don't have to have one. But it's none of their business what other people do.
Well, I think it is because there's
no,
the
it isn't.
Of being a
no,
human
it isn't.
Being.
It is none of their business. If you think it's wrong, don't have an abortion.
I know, exactly. And, it's cool people have the freedom to make that choice, but calling her a slut...
They only have the freedom to make the choice because people like Sarah Palin are not the president or the vice president.
Yeah, and then you're also slandering Palin, saying she's such a horrible mom from what being president.
She is!
You never said anything about Bill Clinton.
She's leaving her little... She's gonna leave her little retarded crumb cruncher back in Alaska so she can go to Washington, D.C. and be the vice president. This is somebody who's talking about conservative family values, and she has a kid and she drops it off so she can go run off to D.C. and become the vice president. What kind of conservative family values are those?
What kind of liberal are you?
No, answer my question. Answer my question. What kind of conservative family values are those?
She's empowering her girls, her daughters, to be the people they want to be.
Empowering them, my ass! She had a kid 4 months ago who has Down syndrome, and she's going to leave that kid with somebody else while she goes off to Washington, D.C. Meanwhile, she goes to Washington, D.C., and her idea is to spout what she calls conservative family values. What kind of conservative family values is it to take your four-month-old kid with Down syndrome and leave him off with a babysitter somewhere?
Well, see, it's because you come off like you're some sort of traditional.
No, this is not about me. I'm asking you.
Okay.
Who is she? This is not about me. This is about Sarah Palin. What kind of conservative family values is that? She's preaching one thing. Meanwhile, she takes her retarded little kid and drops him off with somebody else so she can run off and be vice president. Now, if she is such a family values advocate, why isn't she at home ironing her husband's shirts and taking care of her little retard kid?
Okay, because, you know,
answer the question. Answer the question. Answer the question. Answer.
A woman can't be a mother and a full-time worker. You think single
That's
moms
right.
can't work full-time?
They can't. That's
can't.
Right. If they believe in conservative family values, no, they can't. These are the people telling
so
women they need to stay home and raise their
kids.
Children. What's that?
So a father can't be president.
I'm talking about people who espouse conservative family values. They espouse traditional gender roles. Or don't you know that?
No, I do not. Conservative family values worked back in the day when women had to work.
I'm not espousing them. Sarah Palin espouses them. Sarah Palin is espousing them, not me.
So she's going, okay, so Palin's going around saying all women should stay at home, wear bare feet, and iron shirts. Then I'd say, yes, she's a hypocrite. But she's
That's
not
pretty much
that.
What she's saying.
Okay, so you can quote her on that.
Everybody except her. It's just like Dr. Turkey Neck, who did the same exact thing. You should stay home with your kids and raise them while she's busy running around the world doing book tours. Outrageous. Can you tell? This is a brand spanking new episode of the Tom Likas Show. Write to us, Tom@BlowMeUpTom.com.
The Tom Likas Show.